Do you want to know how we lived the first week with the advanced micro-CHP? I mean the small combined heat and power system with a gasoline generator and with the heat pump. It was fascinating, to say at the least.
Oh yeah!
It needs fossil fuel, yes, but we get nearly 3 times as much energy from 1 liter of fuel compared to other genset users. In the USA it's probably even cheaper to make heat and power yourself than taking it from the grid. The system is a first step to make a more sustainable use of fossil fuels, and it makes also possible to live off-grid, also in the midst of the winter. In this moment, I'm running the gasoline generator at 80% power and supplying energy to our Victron energy manager that is at the moment charging the batteries with 35 ampere and it's at 24 volt, and also powering a few consumers on the house grid like fridge, lights and a computer. Together that happens to be this 1.37 kilowatt. What is going on here? Dear Energy Independence, I'm Norbert, energy engineer. In video number 84, I explain how we used a brand new CHP system during its first week. It is advanced because the generator's heat is nearly 100% recovered. And it's also advanced because the amount of this heat is well matched with the heat pump, of which the outside unit is installed in the garage and not outside. And in this way, we will have much more heat than otherwise possible with the heat pump or with this recovered heat. In one word, you have nearly 3 times as much energy from each liter of gasoline, and that's another step towards sustainable living. This match between heat pump and generator means much more heat for the winter and electricity at the same time, with maximum efficiency. Imagine it with a blackout or even off-grid living. You will have much more off-grid time with each liter of fuel. So let's start with the setup. This is the heart of the system, a gasoline generator, hardly modified for heat recovery. Here's how the whole system works. It has 3 aspects, electric, hydraulic and thermal. The Victron Multiplus is at the center of the system. The internal unit is controlled by the external unit, where the power comes into the heat pump. The hydraulic scheme includes the exhaust gases through the radiator and also the 2 units of the heat pump that are connected by refrigerant pipes. This is the thermal scheme. The radiator and engine deliver heat in the garage, taken by the evaporator. The garage and all the things inside function as heat storage, so the heat pump can work also well without generator. That's a lot of interconnections, right? So you have to think about those relationships during operation and make it as automatic or autonomous as possible.
The generator produces electricity, but instead of wasting lots of heat, we feed it into the cold side of the heat pump, which brings it to our kitchen. The heat is produced at 2 different temperatures. Exhaust gases go into this radiator, and the inbuilt air cooling takes the heat from the engine. That is heat at a lower temperature. Both heat sources act as an integration for the cold that is produced with the outside unit of the heat pump, keeping our garage at a stable temperature. During an experiment of 45 minutes, the air temperature in the garage increased by 0.6 degrees Celsius. The electricity powers our home. One generator outlet goes directly to the heat pump that is at 1 meter distance. It's very nice to have a heat pump with an inverter inside, so that the generator will never have to supply high start currents. The second outlet of the generator goes to a Victron charger inverter, which passes the grid-like electricity to the house, but also charges our batteries. This Victron, a great product I already reviewed in my video 43, has also an input connection to the main grid. When needed, for example with a blackout, it transforms the stored energy again to grid-like AC voltage. It even gives the possibility to go beyond the maximum contract load of the supplier, with a function power assist. Then you simply add the power of the grid with that of the battery. The same works also for adding the battery power to the generator power. From the other side, the Victron divides the input power from the grid or the generator to your consumers in-house, a simple pass-through with a relay, and for charging the battery, for example when it is only half full. That can give an overload on the generator. I have to manage that because the generator gives only half the power of what the grid can give me. Stay tuned, because this channel might just be the right solution for blackouts, high energy bills, and off-grid living. Also in developed countries, the grids are not following the quickly rising demand, caused for example by electric vehicles and heat pumps. I am in favor of this massive electrification of temperature control at home and mobility, but they are big electricity users, and the global trend will leave you in the dark if energy supplies are not able to follow. Remember this warning. Let me help you to save energy, to protect the climate, and also to be secure of your energy supply when weird things happen in the outside world. Put your thumbs up and subscribe to the channel with a notification. I make usually one video a week. That will not fill your inbox. Now let's see the system in action. Here is it working at its leisure. The generator is producing only 420 volts. For a few essential consumers in the house, 140 watt. And heat pump, when it is just maintaining the temperature, the remainder of this 420 volts. The generator has to supply only a third of its power. Thanks to its inverter, the generator will adapt the fuel consumption still better to this low load than a generator without it. 500 watts is something that you can surely maintain also with a battery during about 4 hours without discharging the lead batteries beyond 50%. I bought lead and not lithium because it's thought for short blackouts and not for doing many deep cycles. If the heat pump is not working, then the 2 kWh of the battery is good for many more silent hours. How to control the power to the battery without asking too much to the generator? I had to reprogram the Victron in order to limit the charging current to 33 ampere. There's then still excess capacity for a heat pump of 600 watts, and that is enough. So the generator's capacity is enough for charging batteries at a fair speed. The heat pump and some essential users in house like fridge, some lights and the computer. But remember, with a power assist function, the Victron can use the batteries to add power to the generator's capacity. That is channeled through the Victron to the house. Note that the system components are rather well fitting to each other. From the electrical viewpoint, the generator can charge the battery pretty fast, run a few essential consumers and heat a big room with about 2.7 kW. This load is rather predictable and close to the generator's optimal working regime. When the battery is getting full, it will automatically get less power and allow more capacity for other consumers. From the thermal viewpoint, the heat from the generator is about the same as the heat pump is taking from the garage. If you now switch off the generator for the whole night, the full batteries have enough energy for a load of 250 volts, at least with our batteries. Moreover, the heat pump can continue to extract heat from the garage, which will simply cool down a few degrees. The system COP, or the coefficient of performance, is more or less 5 due to a small temperature difference between garage and living room. It even doesn't make condensed water at the usual 15 degrees Celsius. In these calculations, you see the real capacity of our batteries of 60 kilograms. It is possible for us to reset the house kilowatt hour meter at the moment we go in inverter mode, so that we have the state of charge of the battery. The heat power of a gasoline generator is about the double of the electrical power. Therefore, you use only 1/3 of the chemical energy in the fuel if you use only the electricity. If the gasoline generator works at 60% and the heat pump at full power, then the temperature in the garage will stay at the same level. 1 liter gasoline has 9 kWh of chemical energy, and the genset makes 3 kWh of electricity with it. In theory, the gasoline generator can work 2 hours on 1 liter of fuel at nearly maximum power. The electrical capacity of the genset is enough for charging the battery, the heat pump, and a few essential users, but the battery itself can give extra power when needed. If the temperature in the garage is 15 degrees Celsius, that's a piece of cake for the heat pump. It will reward you with a COP of 4.5, so it will give its nominal 2.7 kW of heat with only 600 watts, good for a room of about 4 × 5 meters. If you compare the costs of heat and power from the grid with your self-made heat and power per kilowatt hour, you get in this example 1.5 euro. Compare it with what you pay for this liter of gasoline. It will be close to break even in Europe. In USA, the gasoline costs much less. Tell me in the comments what you calculated. Anyway, there is no price for freedom. Of course, it wasn't all smooth sailing. Here are some challenges I faced and how I overcame them. I will try a footpath of the radiator instead of a water level of 10 cm inside it. The reason is that I saw a lot of water vapor at 35 degrees Celsius coming out of the outside wall, and that contains a lot of energy. It was also difficult to monitor the water level inside the radiator. An external footpath of the narrow radiator can be very low. The metal of the radiator will distribute the intensive heat from the exhaust gas quickly through the metal to the footpath, which is very close to the gas inlet. So the gaskets between the vertical elements will never come much above the temperature of the footpath, which is easy to monitor and to control. Regarding materials, I initially used a plastic pipe for the last 20 cm of the outlet from the radiator, because I had not the 18 mm metal tube, but soon bought a copper pipe when I noted that the outlet of the radiator reached 40 degrees Celsius. I would like a fan on the radiator. When the radiator will run dry in this way, it is better to install a small fan so that the exhaust gases will leave the house at a lower temperature. And then automatic control. There are a few parameters that I would like to control automatically. For example, with Home Assistant, see video number 60 on this channel, or other microcontrollers like Arduino. For example, the generator will give less heat if it generates less electric power, and you can use that in a control strategy. This micro CHP is an exceptionally efficient solution that provides the freedom to live off-grid while meeting your energy demands. I carefully matched all the components to each other to ensure that the system is practical, reliable, and capable of operating itself with minimal intervention. This means that you can focus on your own things without constantly managing your system. But like any system made of subsystems, it can be improved over time, and critical observation during the first times is useful. Anyone with fair do-it-yourself skills can build the system, and certain parts can be delegated. For example, let the installation of the heat pump to professionals, at least the refrigerant part, considering the legal implications of releasing a potent greenhouse gas. If you found this video helpful, please let me know in the comments. What would you like to see next? Maybe a deeper dive into a control system or how to optimize costs or safety. Together, we can make a more resilient and energy efficient future. See you in the next video.